I like Deontay.
Why? You know him personally.
He's faster. He's more athletic. And then you talk to Fury, and Fury has you believing. And in the same way Fury, what Fury did against Klitschko, he moved away from that right hand. He could do the same thing with Wilder. I don't know if he's been off too long or if he's vulnerable psychologically, but it's a really interesting fight. I loved Wilder, and, you know, I like Fury a little bit now, too. Nothing would surprise me in that fight. I still go with Wilder, but nothing would surprise
me. Okay, give me your top five pound-for-pound fighters. There's so many great fighters in the world today. You have Lomachenko, you have Mikey, you have Crawford, you have Spence, you have Wilder, you have Joshua, you have Canelo.
Crawford, Loma, Canelo, Spence, Mikey.
Mikey Spence, what do you think? It looks like it might happen.
I'm not crazy about the fight. I know that Mikey is. It doesn't, you know, if he wins, he's the best fighter in the world. But if he beats Crawford, he's the best fighter in the world. He beats Lomachenko, he's the best fighter in the world. I think Lomachenko is a more natural matchup. I think Crawford actually is a more natural matchup. They have history going back to the amateurs. But, you know, he could, in theory, he could try to unify 135 and 140. That would make history, too. I mean, if he must see something in Spence that the rest of us don't. But, you know, I think that there are easier ways to get Rick recognized as the best in the world. Also, I understand that any fighter goes in there, risks everything, or has to be willing to risk everything.
Yeah.
So I give him more respect than that, and I think that he is a great, great fighter. But he's not. But he's still playing with house money, if that makes any sense. I mean, if he loses, he lost to a much bigger guy. He lost to a guy who debuted at 154 and walks around at what, like about 170. You know, so then there's no shame. There's no shame in losing. I think that he's risking more in a potential loss to Lomachenko, and I'd probably have him favored against Lomachenko too.
And that's a huge fight. Now, Mark, you wrote a book about Pistol Pete.
Yeah.
That went crazy viral, as they say.
Right. It's that was before viral.
That was before viral. Like but everybody bought it. Everywhere you go, that everyone
did you buy
has
it.
I have seen it. I've seen it. But I've seen it in places. Then you wrote a book about Mancini, who also, the book did phenomenal. I think they even made a TV show or a movie out of that book? A documentary, yeah. Sorry. What's your next big project? You could tell us.
I don't have one.
You're too busy?
No, I had one, I had to pack it up, and I'm not
Why?
Telling you.
Okay. Business?
ESPN, the boxing stuff started.
Speaking of which, so right now, you covered NFL. And NFL is so mainstream. When you veered more and more towards boxing, where people say, Mark, what are you doing? Stay with the NFL. Boxing is dead. Right. Boxing's not going anywhere. Do you ever hear that or no?
I like boxing.
Of course you do. And now boxing is back. I think boxing is more popular now than it was 5 years ago.
No, I think boxing's back, Ellie, because of you.
No.
I'm going to go walk the dog now, right?
Okay.
All right.
There you have. Tell me where to follow you.
Mark, what am I?
Mark
_ Kriegel on Instagram. Hold on. I'm getting all my social media. And at Mark Kriegel on Twitter.
All right. There you have. Make sure to follow him. And you can tune in to ESPN and ESPN Plus. He broadcasts the boxing. FuseCenterPoint.com. He's back reporting.